wrong. She wrong? Right about now, we're going to have a toast.
Yeah.
By Siobhan Matthews.
Hello, everyone. It's a very wonderful day and a very beautiful occasion, and I feel honored to be my dear best friend and brother, Eric Squad's best man. I want to share with you guys a story, story time. I got the mic, so you guys can listen. Anyway, one moment. Okay. And this story is actually for Elizabeth. I think it has a moral to this story. It's an experience that happened to me with Eric upon the first time that we met, and I think it would be good for your marriage. When we first met, anyone who knows Eric knows that he's the most outdoorsy person that you can ever meet. And he asked me if I've ever been canoeing before, and I told him, no, I haven't been canoeing. And he was appalled. You've never been canoeing before? Anyhow, I saw this sense of excitement got in his face as he started to plan our first canoe trip. And the day came and he was like, okay, I got everything ready. He went on, he pulled out his maps, he found the easiest path that would be for a beginner, yet he made sure that it had enough water that was able to ride down the slope. It was from the top of a mountain to the very bottom. And so I was like, okay, I'm excited. So on that particular day, he said, well, buddy, I think it's going to rain today. So I want you to be extra protected because I don't want the water to rise too high that we might get in trouble. So I said, okay. He said, we'll buy some ponchos at a store up in the mountain. I took to myself, ponchos at a store in the mountain? That doesn't sound right. Anyway, maybe it's a Walmart. There's a Walmart everywhere. But we got up to the mountain, and sure enough, it was just like a little corner store. And we went in, and I asked them if they sell ponchos, and they looked at me like I was speaking a different language. And so, no sooner that I said that, he said, look at these might work. So I looked at him, and I said, what might work? So he grabbed some garbage bags, and I want to give you guys a good visual. Yes, so it looks something like this. And so I said, okay. Maybe this might work to protect from the rain. And he was like, oh, but you know, the water might be too high and you might fall and bump your head. I don't want that to happen. So you need a helmet. So you put a helmet on me, like this. And so I was like, okay, no problem, good, feeling safe. And then he was like, well, in case you don't know how to swim that good, although I'm from the islands, you'll need a life jacket. So I placed on the life jacket, and this was me, outside of the store. I looked back at the store, and I saw the ladies who were in the store, they were smiling. I was like, maybe they think I'm cute, so that's good. So I'm walking back to his van, and then in the reflection in his mirror, I just took a look at myself, and I was like, ah! I almost fainted. The story goes on. He said that this is the most safe way that we should be, so I agreed. No one was going to see us on this little creek, so I went looking like this. And we got on the where the water was, and first we put the canoe on, and the water was really high, and then we started going, and about a minute or two later, we ran into rocks. There was no water in this creek, and so we were just like paddling on rocks, trying to get the water to go, so you're like, okay, this is not working. So we got out the boat, took the boat up until we got to water, put it back down, paddled some more. About a second later, we got into the rocks, got out the boat, picked up the boat, carried down. And this continued for about an hour and a half. And I was like, Eric, I don't think this is working very well. And so we just got a laugh out of it. And so it was like, okay, well, I'm gonna run back up to the van and then I'm gonna come back down and meet you with the canoe. How does that sound? I was like, okay. He's like, it should take me about a 30 or 45 minute run. I was like, okay. So we got out and we pulled the canoe up. And then as soon as we pulled the canoe up, we looked up and there was the van, right there. We did not go anywhere this whole time. So I looked at that story, and the moral of the story is that though sometimes life, especially in marriage, being married by myself, might seem to get a little difficult, look a little weird sometimes and funny, with Eric, I believe you're going to have a heck of a good time, and you're definitely going to have a great story at the end of life to tell. If he's a good and a true friend, and he will look and protect and watch over you. So to Eric Spar and Elizabeth Spar, congratulations.
Okay, that was a toast, so hold your glasses high. Here's to the bride and groom. You're here. Okay, I say let's eat.
Come on.
But right about now, we're going to have the father-daughter dance. We ask Mr. Fleming, would you please escort your lovely daughter to the dance floor? The song they have chosen is called Sunrise, Sunset.
Is this the little girl I carried? Is this the little boy at play? I don't remember growing older. When did they? When did she get to be a beauty? When did he grow to be so tall? Was it yesterday when they were
thank you.
Give them a big hand. Big hand. All right. Bridal party. Bridal party, where are you? Bridal? Okay, we got ready for the bridal party. Okay.
Thank you.
bride. I have a special request from the bride and groom. Will all married couples, please come to the dance floor. All the married couples, please come to the dance floor. All the married couples. Okay. All married couples. That includes you too. Eric, that's you. That's you and me. Okay, the song I'm getting ready to play.
He's working.
Okay. Now, the way this goes, all the married couples on the floor. If you've been married only 5 years, you may take your seat. Okay. Well, I didn't tell you this generation, man. No, not the bride and groom. No. You've been married. Okay. If you've been married less than 15 years, you may take your seat. Wow. Okay. We got three couples on the floor. And now, if you've been married less than 18 years, you may take your seat. Okay, very finally realizing I'm married. Okay, if you've been married less than 22 years, you may take your seat. Wow, this is good. My wife is sitting down. If you've been married less than 25 years, you may take your seat. I'm running out of numbers. If you've been married less than 28 years, you may take your seat. If you've been married less than 32 years, you may take your seat. 35 years, you may take your seat. Holy, we got two couples on the floor. 36 years, 37 years, eternity, 38 years. Holy. Okay, listen. We have one couple left on the floor. And I need to come over and to congratulate them and find out their names.
Hi.
Hello. I'm John Senich.
Sandy Senich.
Okay. How long have you been married?
39 years.
Wow. 39 years. Big hand, 39 years. Now, what I need you to do, I need you to take this microphone and go over to the bride and groom and explain to them, to them, what it takes